Hello everyone. In this lecture, I would like to discuss about scalable computing over the internet. First, we will see what are the topics to be covered here. So here, I'm discussing about the scalability and its types. So in the scalability over the internet, we have multiple topics to discuss. So today, I'm going to discuss about the age of the internet computing and the subtopics what are involved in this one. The first one I'm going to discuss is scalability. So what is a scalability is? Is a capability of a system to change and adapt and to handle or growing the diminishing the workload what you are representing. Means the works like database storage and the software presentation and the nodes what it is representing and then next what are the infrastructures what it is providing, whatever it is, what it has to do is nothing but they should be grow and then they should be diminishing also. So likely what we're doing is nothing but based on this we are providing this system has a capability and the system has not this such capability to process this. So based on that thing the infrastructure is specified as a scale out, scale in and then scale up and then scale down. So there are the four different types of the scalabilities which are depends upon the systems what we are using here. So the first one, what it is, scaling out. So how you are representing it is a scaling out is, it is a horizontal scale. So why we say it is a scaling out and why we represent it is it as this type of scaling means. Here, what we do is, we need to add more components to your infrastructure. So why we need to add the infrastructure is, here I took an example is, I'm having a web server. So what the web server does is nothing but it is accepting the things from the different web nodes or the different nodes and then what it is doing is it is the request is what it is accepting is processor and it is giving the responses. So here we have the multi-millions of or the billions of the users and these billions of the millions of the users has been traversing using these only web server means there is a concept or there is a means the increase in the traffic there. So what we need to do here, we need to increase the web servers there. So what I am doing is nothing but I am increasing my the capability of this accessing the request here. So there's data, I am not increasing the data storage here. What I am doing is nothing but I am increasing the accessing factors here. So what is the accessing factor here is a web server. So what these web servers do is nothing but these belongs to same cloud only. They are not situated in other clouds. What it does is it is going to handle multiple requests of the user and then it will give the responses to them. So adding of the more components is present as a scaling out. And coming to the scaling in, so what it does is here, so there I am in the previous example, what I am doing, I am increasing the web servers here. So here what I am performing is it is a horizontal scaling only. What it is doing is it is reducing the capacity of your system. And how it is going to reducing the capacity of the system means you have what this infrastructure you are using is means it is highly processed, highly end means then it the what it does is nothing but the work which has been processed by the 10 systems which will be processed by the single system or the single processor only. So by that concept, what we are doing here is that we are decreasing the number of the components or the nodes and what we are providing is nothing but the things what are we are taking from the different nodes or being arranged or being means collected at each tier. And then next that what the web server what it does is nothing but it will transfer the information to the others. Means individually the nodes are not connected to the web server. What it does is the different web servers what you are having, different nodes so you, what you are having or being collectively formed by a channel and then next these channel represented as a web server tie. These web server ties will be connected to the another web servers what you are having. Means you can have many web server ties here. So what it does is nothing but it is individually collecting the data and then processing. By that what it does is nothing but it is representing the scale means what it you are having is the there is a decreasing and then next it will the remove means it will remove the capacity what it is there will be pressurized will be there it will remove the capacity of your system there. And the second sorry third one we are having is the scaling up. So the scaling up is represent is the scaling up and the scaling down will be represented as a vertical scaling. So what it does is nothing but it is completely enact with a single component or a single node only. So here it will take a single node or a component, it will concentrate on that thing. So if you are scaling up, means you are increasing its capacity. Means how we are going to increasing the capacity here is, the concept is you are increasing it means what the processing, what the hard disk you are using, and the next, the CPU spaces, what you are providing. These are the tasks, or these are the things you have to consider here. So whatever the things you are specifying will be increased, and the next, the processing will be done in the as usual way. So here the scaling up represents is we add the resources to that single component only. We don't need to add the another components or other things. We use this component and make it is as they are as usual representing as a multiple things what it is having. Means it can handle multiple things, or it can have the load what you are having, the capacity of the load if it increases, it can handle also. So how it is going to perform these things is nothing but you will boost up the things. So that is the CPUs what you are providing, and the memory spaces what you are using, so database servers what you are providing will be boost up there. And then next you will provide, that is a scale, that is it is a capable of accessing all the things what it has done, not done earlier. And coming to the fourth one, there is a scaling down. So here the scaling down means it is completely opposite to the scaling up. Here we are, what you are doing, what you are increasing the capacity of that thing. Here what you are presenting is we are decreasing. So you are, why we need to decrease is nothing but now at a time, at this time, I don't need the such types of things, because I don't need high speed and the that much database servers or the data space. I don't need this type of things at this time, at this particular of time. What I need to do is nothing but I have to reduce all the things what I added to earlier. So the reduction of this process will be done, specified as a scaling down. So these are the things we are having in the scalability. And after that, we are having another one, that is a why we need to consider the parallel computing and the distributed computing. So parallel and then distributed computing, why we need to specify. So here the thing is the scalability, we are discussing about the internet. So internet or the internet computing, here we are going to discuss. So what is the usage of the internet and why you are specifying the internet in processing the data and like that. So these are the first initiation took here. So first initially what you do is we are using the centralized system. So for everything, for every processing or for everything, what they do is nothing but, so a centralized system has been used there, and then if any problem has been faced by any user or anything, so these were the problems has to be transferred to that centralized system. And what it does is nothing but it will solve the problems and suggest the solutions there, and then processing what the thing has been happening is closed there itself only. But it is not the means accessing on the processing all these things and kept things in the centralized system is not the thing we need to support here. So what they done is nothing but there could be another one, that is a, there could be another type of the computing will be there, that is a parallel and the distributed computing has to be used. Why we need to provide the parallel and the distributed computing for these means, we have the large scale of the problems here. Means we are processing through the internet. So in there we can have many problems will be there, and then next multiple computers will be asked to the request the web servers to the same problem also, to the multiple problems also. And everything has to be handled by the single system or the centralized system is not a means appreciate one. So what we need to do is nothing but there could be another solution for that one. So we are providing the two solutions there. So for first one you have the parallel computing. So what it does is simultaneously it is going to execute. So how it is going to execute the simultaneously means we are having the divide and conquer. So first we will take the large problem, and then next what we do is nothing but we will divide into the smaller chunks. That is, for example, it is gonna, when you are processing into the testing, what you do, you will go for the unit and the next integration and the next. First we will start with the smaller units. So what it does is nothing but it will take the problem same as it is. What it does is it is divided into the smaller one. So at the smaller ones, what it does is nothing but these things what I have divided, has to be checked, has to be tested, has to be processed at the same time. Not that another means first you will check the some chunks or the some transfer small some modules by at one time and the other one chunks at the one time, not like that. So what we need to do is nothing but we need to provide all these things at the same time, and then next whatever the things you have in means once we have processed the chunks means you will get some output, or it can be from the interfaces or anything. So what it does is nothing but it simply integrate all these things, and then what the thing it is going to do is nothing, but it is representing that is I am having the solution for your problem. This is the thing what you are having. So here another one, this is the parallel computing, and the another one is the distributed computing. So the distributed computing or the distributed system, what it does is nothing but, so it is having the multiple computers are there, and then these computers are connected to a means one network, any network what they are using. So what it does is nothing but it is split up the problems there, and then next they are going to perform is nothing but they are performing the things by message passing. So they will interchange the message and then say I am getting this type of error, I am getting this type of the processing here for this execution or for these things like that. They will compute, means in parallel computing what they do is nothing but many processes will be executed at the same time. But here what we are doing is nothing but we are including many computers to handle this problem here. So that is a parallel, and then next distributed computing. So after that we are having the first topic in your scalability of the internet computing. So here the age of internet computing, why we need to consider the internet computing, why we need to consider the internet over processing these things here. So the first representation for what you are having is the data centers. So why we use the data centers is nothing but to store the data. The data centers indeed are separately or represented as a cloud itself. So what the cloud says is nothing but I will store your data, whatever the data you are representing. It is not the data for your business, or it is not the data for your IT or anything. If you want to store the data, whatever the data you are presenting, means what the service provider it is choosing, it will store. So these data centers, what it does is nothing but it has to be accessed. So the data centers will be accessed by the internet only. So because without internet, we can't connect to the your cloud or anything. Because if you are having the Google Drive also, any OneDrive or anything you are representing, so what it does is nothing but it will ask for your connection first, and then next what you have to buy that only, you will access your data there itself only. So here the thing what you are using is it must utilize the internet for processing. So for that, the data centers and the supercomputer what we are providing has to be met the demands or the met the things what asked by the millions of the users. So the what you are providing is it is should be by the internet. So when you are specifying through the internet, you are having the two different computings here. So that is first one, high performance computing, and the next one is a high throughput computing. So this performance computing is completely based on the performance, means how it is going to process and how it is going to exhibit itself. If you are processing in the speed one and in the data performance or anything, means how it is going to represent itself is a HPC. And then its throughput, how we are going to specify is, so here the throughput is how the data is accessing, means it is you are not presenting is not the good thing. What it is, how the data is representing, how the data is traveling, like means if you are processing the data at the high speed, means your performance is good. So the performance of the thing is probably is measured by the throughput here. So the systems what you are using here is been divided here into the HPC and then HTC. So what the HPC says is here is, so it will take the performance how we are going to means the data has been sent to the user for a particular amount of time only. Means you will check for 1 day or for 1 hour, for 2 hours, or means for a period, small periodic time only. It is based on the performance. So if you coming to this throughput, it is not based on the small period of time. It will take the processing has been start from earlier. And now means it is after 1 year, or you may consider for the 2 years or anything based on it. So if you are considering for the 1 year, so from the 1 year earlier, from the first day has been used the data center, which has been used by the user, and what it is happening means how he is going to access the data. Means you are how you are providing the data, when you are buffering or you are providing in the high speed, or there is any problem is there like that, what it does is nothing but it will completely get the data details for the 1 year. means where you are providing the periodic time from only 1 year, 1 month, or the 1 hour, means some smallest periodic time while you are considering the HPC. So you are nowadays we are using the high speed networks or the high speed users. What you are specifying is many means fastest one. So for the based on that thing, the HPC is not means provided appreciable for these type of things. So what we use is HTC, that is a high throughput computing here. So what this do is nothing but it will means we need to specify any, we need to go for the another tool like that, not here. So what it does is nothing but it is completely imaged with your clouds what you are using there. And then next, it supports only the internet computer, not like that. It also used in the parallel and the distributed computings also. And you are having the first one is platform evolution. Why we need to provide means why we need to use the internet technology, that is the internet computing, here is evaluated here. So first thing is what are you having, that is a computer technology is provided. How we are going to step by step, how you are going to provide if this is one is a useful or this is not the useful, like that. What it does is nothing but by the age to age, and then next what it is doing is from time to time how it is going to perform and how it is going to change itself is described here. So you are having some generations here, that is the 5 generations of the development I am having here. So here first and then earliest one what I consider is a 1950 to 1970. What it is specifies here, it is having the mainframes, and then next another, that is IBM 60 and the series 64, for what they are designed. Means they are completely designed for the demands of your large businesses and the government organizations only. Means they are not completely used for the common basis or the people what they are providing. So they are used for only businesses and government organizations only. And then next development of the generation took it 1960 and 19, means parallelly it is 1950 to 1970, and then parallelly 1960 to 1980 what it is considering the low cost mini computers there. So what it is providing these computers is, that is a DEC, PDP-2 and then VX services. So the first one means the earliest one, which is IBM 360, is completely concentrated or the it means giving the benefits to the large businesses only. And what it is doing here is nothing but the second phase of one or the second generation of the development provides the smallest one, means not all the biggest one, but the smallest one business are considered. And some college campuses also can use these computers for their processing. And coming to the third one, 1970 to 1990, we are using the PCs there. So which are built with a VLSI microprocessor. PC here, why we need to means everyone have their electronic device to store their data and to access, and then next to do and then process anything. Like that, what did you have to do? 1970 to 1990, we have the PCs development. And coming to the 1980 to 2000, so we have the portable computing circuit. So the portable computers, why we are using, means not all the time we are sitting at the place, we are accessing the things. Sometimes we need to go for the meetings or all time. In the meanwhile, what you have to do, you have to check for your presentations or you take, go for the any changes or anything. What you have to do is nothing but you need to maintain your device there. So which is should be a portable, means you should carry at any time and to any way. So which is a both wired and wireless has to as considered. And then next after that we are having is since 1990 after that we are using the both HPC and HTC system. So how it is specified is, it is specified that they are hidden in the clusters and the grids what you are using in that. And these systems what you have provided is a high end, and then it's web scale, the computing, and then it's information services are considered for the both the consumers and then next employed what they are using. So this is the platform evolution of your computer technology. And then next we are having the evolutionary changes which has been brought in the parallel distributed computing along with this HTC and the HPC systems. HTC means high throughput system, and then next year you are using the high performance system. So what means here, you are representing what it is using to achieve this thing. So first I'm providing the HTC system. What it uses, it is a disparate nodes it is using. And it is providing a network that is a peer-to-peer network it is providing. And what the thing it is doing here is it is providing a file sharing here. So the throughout the network and the process using the network, what it is doing is it is providing a file sharing for the accessing of the users. So here, what is the control here? So the control, how we are going to provide is a distributed one. Means no one is using, means for example, I am the one, I will control like that. It is not like, so it is based on your, means I am providing a file, how we are going to, means if you are providing a file, I am giving the file. So I will like to give some permissions to the, some credentials to that thing. So who will access and how come it can be accessible and then it's what are the things it. So distributed control means what it is going to perform has to be decided by the users or the providers what they are using. And then next I am having the another one that is how I am going to provide the computational the data grids. So for this I am using the geographical space. In this thing what I do is nothing but it is providing the things that is a computational one. And then I am having the another one that is another last end is web servers, the web 2.0 services, and the next internet clouds, and then internet of the things. So how I am going to do is here is a service oriented architecture, that is which is a SOA. So what this SOA provides is here is nothing but here having the multiple things in the later on in the next slide, in the coming slides I will discuss what the service oriented architecture will provide and how we are going to access the things. There are three paradigms are there, systems are there, we are using these things. And then next by virtualization we are using the internet clouds. So on coming to here, we are having the HPC system. The high performance system is using the homogeneous nodes. Means homogeneous nodes means there is no any connectivity between them. They are just being specified. And how it is going to concentrate or how it is going to provide means it completely concentrate the speed only. Means how I am going to provide only is it is completely on the high speed. It depends upon the high speed. Here I am using the peer-to-peer network and here it is using the clusters. And then next, what the control IT is providing the centralized control. Means everything has to be controlled by a system which has been situated at somewhere. And here I am providing the geographical sparse and what it is using is the clusters here. So based on the means based on the data and then it's based on the behavior of that thing, it will place the things here. So to this HPC system provides is RFIDs and the sensors. This RFIDs means there will be the tags will be there and then by using the electronic electromagnetic fields, what it does is nothing but it will represent what it is using. Means by using these electromagnetic fields, it will specify okay this belongs to this thing or it will come to identify. So the identified will be placed into the system there. So this is the representation of the HTCs and the HPC system. And then you are having the why we use these representations means the observations what you have done means here providing the HPC and then HTC what will it do means these HPC contains the supercomputers. So which these supercomputers are replaced by the clusters and these clusters are interoperability means they are going to share the data among them only. So what it does is nothing but it is providing it. Means what is a cluster means I told you based on the behavior and then it's based on the means things what are they having common. Means if I belong to the some community or if I belong to the some network big data and then next if I belong to the some college oriented one, what it does is nothing but it will place my things into that cluster. And then next these clusters what you are doing, so they are physically connected and then the data among them is shared on the network there. Means the virtual whatever they are providing is a physically connected one. And coming to the HTC, it's not like that. What it does is nothing but it will take the distributed system. So what does it is providing apps also to process things. So here what you do is nothing but you will connect it to this HPC or this HPC or HTC computing from anywhere. That is you will sit at the home and then it's coming you will using the internet and what it is allows is nothing but by using some credentials it allows to process you that you will access your data. But in HPC what it is doing is you are whatever the computers you are having are physically connected means you can't use the data apart from that one. But what you have to do, you have to go to your cluster where it is situated and then next you will go for that processing and then next there will only you will access these things. So if at all you are not providing these HPC, what it does is nothing but it is only the restricted one. But here HTC is globally used. Why it is global is means either there is no any physically connected one, and then if there is no any is situated at this only you have to situate, and then it's at this time only you have to check your systems or you have to take the data, like it not had been implemented. What it does is nothing but simply it is going to the globally distributed things. And then next you have the second topic is HPC, that is a high performance computing. So how we are providing the high performance computing is based on the FLOPS we are using. What is a FLOP means? Floating point operation per second. So based on this thing, what you are using is what you are means your system is representing a good thing or not, like that we are specifying. So the first representation what you are using is a GFLOPS, that is a gigaflops you are using. But now we are means in the high speed internet or the high speed providing means the fastest technology in which what we are using is the petaflops. So what are these petaflops or these gigaflops means? That is the operations which has been done but the per second. So these are the means used by throughout the science, engineering, and the next medicine and others are represented. So here how we are going to specify these HPC. Means which is a high speed which are represented on the supercomputers or the mainframes or the server or anything or any servers what you are representing per particular amount of time only. Means if you are considering, earlier I said that is a performance is based on the smallest periodic time only, and this what the smallest periodic time what it takes is nothing but therefore the supercomputing how much data it has been transferred and then next what the speed it is having but this particular amount of the time only thing. So if this particular amount of has been taken, so in this particular amount of it has been performed fastly, or sometimes it may not perform the fastly also. If it is performing the fastly means what it does on based on that particular amount of the time, you can't say that deviate the thing what you are is the computing what you are using is the highly appreciable one. So what we need to is nothing but we need to take the large amount of the periodic time, and then we need to apply all the things, all the measurements, and then after all the thing, all the rubrics on that. What it does is nothing but it will study, and then next it will say okay that the thing is user what your data what they are accessing and what they are processing are represented, and then next process it here within this periodic time very well. Okay. So here only how many systems or the how many processings are used is they are only 10% of the users are using these things, that is a HPC or the high performance computing. Whereas coming to the high throughput computing, what it is doing is here is nothing but so it is completely concentrated on the HyperX computing. Means for example, if you are providing this web server, taking as an example, web server means it has to take the things that is internet searches or the app searches or anything from the millions of the users simultaneously. So simultaneously it is performing means what it has to do is nothing but so it has to shift the concentration on the speed of the things. Means it how it is going to means for example the performance is not based on the multiple task here. The performance is based on the single task here. Means if I am searching for one thing, so how we are going to specify the performances? What I searched is means presented in the particular amount of the time or not. So that is a performance. So when the throughput, what it is saying is it is not completely for the one user. So we are having the multiple users for the means for millions of users for this web server. So what we need to do is nothing but at this particular amount of the time, how many processes are the how many requests are coming from many users and how we are going to tackle it. So that's why what it does is nothing but the goal what you have set is changed here. So the goal is shifted from the speed to the number of tasks completed per unit of time. So how we are going to give the unit of time means, as I said, you can take that it is a year and the next 1 month or one hour or particular minute or second, you can specify all these things. And then next specify here, there is a problem. There is a HTC need to improve the speed, but also to the solve other problems like time availability, cost, security, and reliability. Means here, you are concentrating on the number of the tasks it is completing. So for completing the number of the tasks simultaneously at a time, what you need to do is nothing but you should be aware of the infrastructures what you are using under the web servers, and then next high speed things what you have to providing for accessing these tasks and providing the solutions for the task should be in a high speed manner. So there you should include the cost also. And then next, all over this, we have the security also. And then next, how come it will be accessible like that? We need to provide all these things. So while providing all these things, we need to put in this mind. And then next process will be means done in the HTC, like number of the tasks completed per unit of time, rather than the speed or the rather than the performance means how it is going to complete like that. And then next, you are having the three new generation. That is, as I said, you are having the SOA in the diagram there. So there is a software oriented architecture. So what this service software, the SOA done is see, the web services which are usable, means which are useful for the any user has been available for all tasks. Means for this task only you will use the web service. For this task you not won't use a web service like that. It is not any. So what it does is nothing. What the task you are going to provide or the what the task you are going to access is what it does is here. It is providing the service means web services for all the tasks what you are using. So for that what it does here, it is having this different. You will have the different types of the tasks there. So based on that thing, there is a existency occurred. That is a three new paradigms came to existence. So the first one is a radio frequency identification, alias RFID. So what it does is that thing that this uses the electromagnetic fields. So the tags will be there. So the tags means, for example, if you are using any shopping or anything, what you are doing is nothing but providing the tags there. So what the tag does is nothing but the tag will be say the way the object is residing. Means not only the tags but for the shopping also, what they do is nothing but for the objects also, means object also it is providing the tag. It means what it does is nothing but it will buy the tag. What it is specifying is it is reset. Means if you lost that thing, if you are processing that, mean you can see where it is residing or where it is processing there, like that you process, means use this RFID. And then next you are having the another one, that is a GPS global system process. So what it does is nothing but as I said, that is it is low, means you are using the tag where it is resided along with the GPS also. What it is doing is nothing but where your thing is resided, like that you process. Means you have to for this any system what you are using for the person or what you are providing, what is there is really a chip or anything, they have to enable the GPS. By using the GPS you at this particular time or any time, means for this periodic amount of the time where you traveled and then which way where you resided, like that the information will be good. And then coming to the another paradigm we are having is the Internet of the Things. So these things what you are providing here is nothing but the physical devices what you are using, that is the vehicles, buildings or anything what you are processing is embedded with the sensors here. So what the sensors do is here is nothing but it is providing with the internet. And then next they are having the internetworking possibility. So how you are going to provide the internetting possibility is they are using the software and the network connectivity there. So based on this thing what you are using is nothing but based on the sensors we will collect the data. And then next if you want to exchange the data there itself only, we can use the data through the network only which has been connected through the things. So that is these are the paradigms what you are using there. After that we are having the computing distinctions. We are having four computing distinctions here: centralized computing, parallel computing, distributed, and the next internet computing. The first one is centralized computing. Here the centralized computing, the resources like means the processors, memories, and the next storage or anything. So it has to be used by means one system only. And then next, whatever the things you are going to process or the whatever the things you are going to share has to be put in that system. And these things are monitored by the OSD. Means the things what you are has to be, you have to connect to the centralized system, then you have to take from that only. Means the data what you are going to get is not available at the other systems or other places. What it does is nothing but it simply provides the only one accessing system there. Whereas the parallel computing means it is completely means reverse to that one. There you are providing the parallel processing. So how you are going to provide the parallel processing means you can provide the shared memory there. And then next distributed memory will also be provided. And then next we are having the another, that is the inter-process communication. by using the shared memory or the message passing like that. What you do is nothing but you will interact with the others, and then next you will get the data also. And this computing things what you are having is called as a parallel computing. And the next one you are having is the distributed computing. So what the distributed computing does is nothing but in the parallel computing, what you will do earlier, we said that it is completely based on the process what you are using. That is, we are having the process, what it does is nothing but it will divide the process into the small processes or the larger ones into the smaller ones, and then processing means. Means it is parallelly accessing or the parallelly executing the processes there. Here what we do is nothing but here you are providing the distributed computing, means you are providing the computers there. So here the computers means they are having its own memory, but they are connected one. So the interconnection will be means there will be provided by these connections which are the physical oriented one, and then next they can be connected to a private network or anything. Means they are situated at the same place and are accessing not the allowed one. So what they do is nothing but they are kind of internally connected, and then next how you are going to means communicate, means there is a inter-process communication also. So by that what they do is nothing but they will pass the information and then next exchange, and then by that what do is nothing but they accomplish the task what they are assigned. And then next what you are having, the another one is the cloud computing. So here what you do is nothing but internet cloud is provided here. So the internet cloud can be a centralized one or the distributed one based on the provider or the based on the services what you are using. And the computing technique what you are applying is also the parallel or distributed, or both also we can use. So here how you are going to provide these things is nothing but, so here we are using the physical things what you are having, the storages we can use, and then next apps you can use, and then web servers what you are providing, and then collaborations what you are doing. Likewise, whatever the cloud can be used has been provided there, and we can access all these things right there only by connecting to the cloud what it is providing through the internet what you are having. And then next, the last one we are having is the distributed families. So the distributed system families is it is based on the these effectiveness or the these things. It is describing the distributed system or these must have these things to specify whether it is having the capability to access the things or not. So in the first one, you have the efficiency. So what these do is nothing but how you are going to provide, means this is the efficient or not. So by the speed and the next the programming and the throughput demands what you are having the means achieved. By that what you will do is nothing but the distributed system, that system what you are providing is an efficient one. And then the second one is dependability. What is the dependability says is here is nothing but, so it means if it is providing the good quality of service at any level, means if you are not providing at this level or at that level like that, if you are means testing at any level, what it does is nothing but it is providing the quality of service at any level, then it is called as the dependability. And adaptation in the programming model, what it is does is nothing but its ability to support unending means number of job requests. And means for example, if you are having many requests that you are completely or that is continuously coming to your web server, so what you have to do is nothing but you have to provide the support to that one. So for that what you have to take the model which is going to take the job requests, and then next these job requests has to be applied on the data sets, and then next these were data sets what you have to do is nothing but they will use the cloud resources which are provided by these different models, and then next whatever the request is provided by these users or any other organizations, what they have to do is nothing but they have to handle the request and they have to give the responses or they have to give the results to them. And then coming to the next one, there is a flexibility. Here what you are doing is nothing but it is either these distributed systems what you are providing is has the ability to run. Means you have to run means if you are using any HPC system or HT system or anything. So any system means HP means if you are concentrating on the speed, then you will use the HPC. And if you are concentrating on the throughput, then you are HTC. So if you are specified, means what are the HPC and HTC computings are there? That is the science and engineering are specified as a HPC, and the next business oriented one are considered as a HTC there. So what it does here, so we will see that it is flexible to any environment or not. means if it is designed for only HPC, that is only performance based, or it is only designed for the throughput based or not, like that, what we lose nothing, but your system is flexible to any environment or not, we will check the one, and by checking what the result it is providing, means if it is providing the high speed along with the throughput also, then we will say that, so it belongs to the both environments and is it is flexible, like that we will specify. So these are the concepts in this age of computing, internet computing we are having. And thank you for listening this time.